Why a woman has not remarried after divorce and is not able to maintain herself after iddat. The liability to maintain her according to the act falls on her relatives in the given order, as her children, her parents, other relatives entitled to inherit her property on her death. While her children are unable to provide maintenance to her, the liability will pass on to her parents. In case a divorced woman fails to secure maintenance from her parents because of their insufficient means or death or any other reason, the responsibility to maintain her falls on the other relatives in the proportion in which they would inherit property. Where any of her relatives is unable to pay his or her share of the maintenance, the magistrate may order that the share of such a relative be paid by other relatives. In addition to the above-mentioned measures, it provides that while a divorced woman is unable to maintain herself and, in rarest of rare cases, has no relative or such relatives do not have means to maintain her, the responsibility to pay maintenance to such helpless woman will fall on the waqf boards established under Waqf Act 1995 or any other law for the time being in force in a state, functioning in the area in which the woman resides. This issue was raised in Secretary Tamil Nadu Waqf Board versus Sayyid Fatima Noji, where a wife filed a petition for maintenance against Waqf Board alleging that she could not get maintenance from the heirs or parents. The same was decreed, against which an appeal was filed with the following objections. Number first, an order under Section 4, Subsection 1 was a prerequisite for maintaining petition under Section 4, Subsection 2. And number second, the Ministry of Welfare, that's Waqf section, had written a letter to the Secretary, Tamil Nadu Waqf Board, Madras, stating that no separate fund was to be created for giving such maintenance nor any guidelines why to be issued to Waqf Board. Dismissing the appeal, court held that an order under Section 4, Subsection 1 was not a sinecure non for filing a petition under Section 4, Subsection 2. And to the second objection, the letter from the Ministry could not override statutory provisions. All Muslims would not be compulsorily bound by the Act. An option is provided to them to choose the law under which they wish their disputed issues to be adjudicated. Section 5 of the Act therefore provides that if a divorced woman and her former husband declare by affidavit or by any declaration in writing, either jointly or separately, that instead of Muslim Women Act 1986, they would prefer to be governed by provisions of Section 125 to 128 of the Criminal Procedure Code 1973, they will be governed by the same provisions.